Hello, I'm Mr. R. Major, a retired lecturer in metallurgy teaching Christianity and Sikhism, and I have in John 21 described why Peter and his brethren could not catch fish at night, pitch night, dark night, no light at all of the moon as was missing. So when they could not catch, the whole night they were struggling to catch a fish. Now this fish is not that ordinary fish, you catch it in the sea. Here Jesus was going to tell you the fish of which Christ Jesus has made us the fishers of men. So men is a big fish, it's not a small fish. So we are made fishers of men. So when the light of Christ appeared in the morning, then it directed, you know, that this is the fishing ground for you on the right fishing ground. Right fishing ground means where the people are eager to listen to your voice and listen to gospel. If you preach gospel in a place where people are drunk with the old wine of the letters, as Jesus was doing in Jerusalem, they were not keen to listen to him. The people who were keen to listen to him, they used to come from villages. And the temple, they were waiting for Jesus to come to preach gospel. And they appreciated. Whereas the temple priest, they are full of jealousy. They wanted to kill him for preaching the gospel. So that's why when I go to Oxford University or into the churches, these dog-colored priests, they are not happy to see me. When I speak something or preach gospel, then they are not prepared to listen to me. They think I have not been to their universities. I am not trained the way they are trained, men of letters, dead in spirit. As I explained the day before yesterday, I went to Oxford University to listen to a lecture by an American theologian. She wanted to speak about the role of women, and she was mentioning Mary. Oh, Jesus was born of the Virgin. And when I asked her, who are the parents of Jesus? She said, God and Mary is the mother. I said, Mary wasn't mother, she was known as woman to Jesus. If God is the Father, which is spirit, so the mother should be of similar nature, spirit, and not flesh. Joseph, they know, is a foster father. This they have acknowledged. But when I told them this, Mary was surrogate mother, oh, they were taken with surprise. Ah, how can you say surrogate mother? New idea. The man sitting next to me, the one who organized the theology lectures there, Vivian Boland, I think his name. That brother said, your theology is a strange theology. So I wasn't surprised, you know, because these people, they are men of letters, dead in spirit. So they won't understand the things of spirit. And then the one of the brother sitting there, then he said, he has seen in a church, you know, where there was a Holy Spirit, our mother, holding tiny embryo of Jesus ready to be implanted into the womb of Mary. And when I asked him, you know, it is same thing I said to you, surrogate mother. Oh no, they won't listen to me. Even then, you know, they don't want to agree with me. They think I'm a madman. So I enjoy there because I preach Christianity with authority. and they are preaching, teaching rather, you know, with no authority, because they read it from this book, that book, and then they reproduce. I don't read any book. My gospel is written over my heart and not in the books. So here I'm going to explain to you Swastika. That was the symbol used by the Nazis in Germany. Remember that religion has nothing to do with politics. When you mix religion with politics, then it is very dangerous. And this you have seen in Germany, when the swastika was put on their armbands and other thing, and they misused the religious symbol. Religion stands for peace and not for war. So here is the meaning of the swastika. The swastika, I just drawn a simple, you know, drawing, which you can copy from the YouTube. And this is, you know, the swastika. It has four legs, you know, four legs of dharma, we call it. This is the Satyug, when it's a full sunlight. Satyug is the yoga of sun, no more moon or anything. So everybody is son of God. So everybody, like Christ Jesus, he is in God and God is in them. So everybody is a very merciful and helpful, and all the qualities you can have. Four qualities are there, which are shame, truth, contentment, and mercy. If you are not contented, you cannot be merciful. Those Samaritan men who picked up the wounded person, he had these qualities, all these four qualities. So he was a Gentile in whom, who was in God and God was in him, or he was a man of light. So philanthropy is the light. Then when you have degradation, Mammon come in, then you have a no more era of sun, but the moon era started. Then you have full moon, that means full reflection of the moon. Remember that John the Baptist represents full moon. He is a witness to the light, sun, but not light. So if you don't get light from the sun, the moon can't reflect anything. So you must have gospel. So this is called the oral Torah, is the written Torah. And sorry, the written Torah and oral Torah. Written Torah is what you see in the books, scriptures, and the oral Torah is His word, which you preach from your heart and not from the book. That is why we call it oral Torah. So new gospel or New Testament is oral Torah that was missing, and Jesus came to fulfill the law. So this is full moon, when you have a shame, truth, and contentment. The mercy is gone here. When mercy is gone, the person is not perfect. So they were imperfect. To make it perfect, they used to serve free meals, free food, you know, to people. Jesus said, you know, if you invite somebody, he invites you back, that is no good. You have earned nothing. Invite those who cannot invite you back. That is called philanthropy. So philanthropic meals, and which we call jug. Okay, they were held, you know, where people were given a meal, you know, free. Anybody who can't afford it, they were given free. Even clothing were giving free, everything, you know, whatever person needed. So the rich people will feed them, you know, then the so that they are contented. Then we have the next one is called Dwapar Age, in which two qualities, two legs remain, which is truth and shame. People are truthful over there, they won't tell lies. And they had conscience too. So that's the, we call Dwapar Yug. That was as King David time. This is Moses time, King David time. And people were fighting against their property or countries, so nobody can enslave them. But when they become in this degradation, when you become Jew of the physical self and not of the heart, here they were Jews of the heart and not of the physical self, then they enjoyed freedom. But when they became Jews of the physical self, of the body, and not of the heart, then they became unfaithful to Abraham. Then they became anti-Semitic themselves. And they call other people, they are anti-Semitic. So, unfaithful to Abraham, people are called tares. Today they are bundled up in Israel for final burning. So when they became tears, shameless, you know, then they create darkness, Kalyug, in which all the qualities of the moon is half moon here. Here, no moon, no moonlight at all. So with the result, we have pitch darkness. That is, we call Kalyug. So when you have pitch darkness, that was the darkness Peter went to fish. He could not catch any fish, you know, because in this pitch darkness, religious darkness, you need the light of Christ to fish men into the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is the golden time to fish. This age, dark age, is golden age for salvation. If you become son of God, then you become eternal like our Father God. So that you become when you eat the flesh of Jesus, or understand what he has said from his mouth, and when you preach that one, then you are drinking the blood of Christ. When you do both, preach, eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the refreshing blood of Christ gospel, when you preach it, then you become like our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. Then you are grafted onto the true vine, which is Christ Jesus, and our Father is a gardener. And then you bear fruit, and then you lead to salvation. Now Christ Jesus was not a hireling. So these dog-colored priests, which are hirelings of Mammon, they have nothing in common with the, this is what I have written, no Christ in your heart, no gospel, but dead letters. This t-shirt design is on my channel. So you can see, you know, that in this dark age, golden age, you easily earn salvation if you have light of Christ in your heart. Light of Christ cannot be obtained from the dead books that they teach in the universities. After teaching them, they put a wrong dog collar around their neck, telling them, hey, you are now men of God. Go and fleece people. They come into the churches and they start teaching what they have learned in the university. They are incapable of preaching. So a person like me, who is a preacher, goes into these churches and tell them, this is the meaning of this parable. They come back, this is not written there. Then I tell them, then why they call it parable? If it's written there, then they should not be a parable. Then they have no answer, but they just reject me. Go away, as they used to do Christ Jesus in Jerusalem. The Jews said, we don't want to listen to you. We have Moses' Torah, and that's enough for us. Go and get lost. And they used to call him son of a Satan. Same way they will tell you when you preach gospel that you are a son of Satan. But don't be worried, because you are preaching gospel not from the book that this man said so, that man said so, but from your own heart. And who has given you this knowledge? Not man, but our Father, God. So we are having Father on our side. Whereas these dog-collared people, they have the university professors on their side, because whenever they teach, they always mention this professor said so, that professor said so, and we say our Father said so. So here you are, you know, the living gospel of our living Father is for the living in spirit men. So these dog-collared priests, when they create sectarian riots, people die. So they are worse than those temple priests to whom John the Baptist called brood of vipers. So these dog-collared priests, they too are brood of vipers. And they are the one leading to sectarian riots, as in Nigeria and other country. I lived in Ghana 14 years. There the people are nice, practical. They have tribal marks on their cheek, which is their identity. So with through that tribal marks, you know, they are saved. People don't kill each other. When they recognize that the man belongs to their own tribe, doesn't matter whether he's a Catholic or a Protestant or a Mohammedan, they love each other. That puts an end to their fighting. But in Northern Ireland, no tribal mark or anything. They just kill because he's a Catholic, the other one is a Protestant. And people like Ian Paisley put on these dog-collar and they incite people. So he's Antichrist. He cannot give account of the people to God. People themselves have to give the account. So anybody who stands between man and God, he is an antichrist. So make everybody solitary. If you make following, then you can't give their account to God. Then you become antichrist yourself. Christ Jesus never made a following. Never said anybody to join him. To follow him. He said, come on, join my company. Join my fellowship. And they joined his fellowship. And they were preached, you know, the gospel of our Father. And here they were given instructions how to prune the wine plant, or in the vineyard of our God, or to look after the vines, so they produce best quality fruit. So anything which is not good is cut off and thrown away into the fire. So our Father God bless you.